What's going on, guys? Mike's Gaming back with another vid. Yeah. I haven't made all this over the third time. Makes sense. Anyway, so like this started my life, kind of blah. I've talked this many times. Anyway, like 2006, I played soccer. That was the only sport I've ever been in. Didn't really play it that well, other than goalie. Makes sense. Not really, but whatever. I look like oily, and I don't know why. This camera, I guess. I don't know. The light behind me. I don't know. I'm not a physicist. I'm not a psychologist. I'm not a physiological person. What? I'm not a person. anyway, so then fast forward like 2010-ish. I had a pool back there. And like, me and my friend Jacob, at the time friend, we were like in the pool and playing at night. And we were playing football with a volleyball and like tackle. And like he went, like I think I had the ball, and like he pushed me under an accident, and like then I come up and my heart starts like beating really fast. I don't know why at the time. So then I'm like, at night, I'm like, I told my mom this. She's like, oh, you'll be fine. So I forget exactly what all she said. Just like, you'll be fine. Don't worry. It'll wear off. And then like, at night, I couldn't sleep at all that night. It was like really humid. And I was like, I didn't want to do anything the next day. I was like, tired as heck, to put lightly. Really? Really? Dumb Mexicans. Dumb Mexicans. Anyway, so like, then I go to my. No. Yeah, then the next. Yeah, that same day. My mom also was in college at the time still, like 2010, so, and like, I was still feeling it all day. I just laid on the couch, did nothing. Then she had to go to college, like, I think it was like 3 in the afternoon. I don't know, I have to think back like 8 years, but whatever. I'm dumb. I'm failing math right now. Click my thumb looks. Anyway, then I went across the street. They took care of me. Laid in bed, did nothing. Then my mom comes and picks me up at like 8 o'clock. And like, I start feeling fine. I feel like I'm gonna like throw up. And then like, I just black out all of a sudden. And like the room starts, I'm starting to get dizzy. Yeah. And then, like, my mom was like, are you okay? Are you fine? We're going to the hospital. I'm just like, I don't know what just happened. Pretty much. So then we went to Swedes. And, pretty much my, what you can call them, like, not my specialist, because I didn't have one at a time, but, like, my regular doctor, I guess I can say, came in and everything. Saw that I was, like, just in bed. My heart was, I think they said my heart was going 230 beats per minute, which is, like, not average. It's usually, like, 180. It's, like, still really high average, but still. Anyway, that was all happening. Then, like, this random dude, his name was Dr. Hu Young. He came. I was already okay because, see, the way they got to go back to normal was put my face in a giant bucket of ice water. Go like this as long as I can, then come out. As I got older, though, it didn't work as well, so I had to go different ways, which I'll get to later. Anyway, like, my specialist at the time came in, said that I had this, like, really rare condition called Wolf Parkinson White Syndrome, and pretty much, car's being annoying. Anyway, that just means that, like, alright, so think of it. Think of it like a giant circuit board, and you have an extra wire for that circuit board. That's pretty much how my heart is. Don't know if that analogy worked or not, but whatever. Think of it like that. And, just pretty much makes my heart go, like, haywire. So then, like, and I was still worrying about school. They kept me in the hospital. They transferred me to from Swedes to Rockford Memorial, where I was actually born. So they kept me there 2.5 days. First day I was just like, I don't want to be here at all. Just like, just 1 year, not even a year yet, being there at this house. And I've been here last 6 or 7. Maybe, I don't know. I know it was like a real long time though. And like, brain, think. I was just like, I can't wait to go home. Like, my mom, like, they had little, like, tiny benches to lay on, or to sit on, not lay on. But my mom used it to lay on. So, just extra context. She laid there night and day. And I was just like, you don't have to do this. Like, my dad came and everything. Saw me. We were also supposed, the worst part about it was, we were supposed to go to both the football, American Football Hall of Fame, and the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. That's where we were supposed to go for a vacation kind of thing, like a couple days later. And my dad, after that, didn't trust me with doing that, since we didn't even know at the time really what caused it or anything. Like, 2 in the morning, I think, is when I was like settled in the hospital bed and all that. Just crazy shit. On my phone, like, how many a year? Because I don't think it's that many, to tell you the truth. Come on, phone. Wolf Parkinson White Syndrome. Yeah, fewer than 20,000 a year. I'm one of those 20,000. Can last for years, they're lifelong. Yep. get rid of it pretty much now. I have to like hold my breath because it makes the blood pressure rise really fast. So it pulls all the blood from the bottom to the top. Then once you breathe out, it pushes everything out. So, and also like the next time I ever get an outbreak, I guess you can call it, to be simple, I'm gonna have to get a giant needle, like a 12-inch long needle, through my groin up to the heart and cut it. And there's only a 50% chance I'll even live. And pretty much, like, the reason, also my doctor said that I probably won't ever be able to play sports until I get fixed. Mainly because of, not many people would be willing to trust it. Like, if it goes off during the game, then I'm pretty much screwed. And then the school doesn't want to be seen as liability and all that, so that's why. So anyway, that's been Mike's Gaming. That's pretty much the short and simple version of my story of why I can't play sports. Anyway, if you did enjoy this, leave a like, please. Go down, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time. Peace.